married again.
It feels good, but exhausting, but definitely good. It's nice that everything is coming together, and so many people are coming here today, too. You're videotaping me.
I am.
Will you be able to figure out this necklace on stage?
I hope so. That's why I'm practicing right now.
Because you can't do it right now.
Yes, I did. I just got it.
Okay.
Do you need a necklace?
It was pretty cool to see Grace, actually, this morning.
Yeah, she was awesome. Oh, yeah. My gosh.
They'd had us do, like, a first look or whatever when they were doing the pictures. So they brought her out, and then, I turned around and saw her, and they took pictures of us as we were, walking towards each other or whatever.
They were hardcore, too. They were like, you can't see him. I'm not the mushroom.
I know.
In the mushroom.
A team of three of them. It's crazy.
Yeah.
How did you find the photographers?
Grace did. Yeah.
We got Justin right here.
So. No, Brian, this is your third event around your marriage.
Kind of, yeah.
Is there going to be one next year?
Maybe. We like to keep people guessing.
Renewal.
Could be an annual thing.
Yeah, make it annual.
Annual Brian and Grace wedding event.
What was the second event then? Because this is
Albuquerque. We got married in
Beverly Hills,
City Hall. And it was a little thing for the family. Last year, we all flew out to Albuquerque.
Uh-huh.
Just a little get-together. Uh-huh. And then we all flew out to Santa Monica. Uh-huh. And next year, we go somewhere closer to home.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You haven't done an East Coast thing yet, so...
No.
No.
We could do an East Coast thing.
It's like a traveling show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Brian,
where would they be next?
When you hit North Dakota.
Brian, let me
how are you coming with that?
Well, I put it together once already, and then I took it around.
Do you want some tape?
They're so red.
Yeah,
man.
Some
duct tape.
Case,
yeah,
little duct tape.
Give you his hand.
There, the lobster claws.
Lobster claws. See, I've gotten that twice already. I'm just practicing, taking it off, putting it on. So this thing, it's like the Indian equivalent of a wedding ring.
Oh, cool.
Mongol Sutra.
No, Indian,
Indian.
Mongol Sutra, right?
Yeah.
That's a cool.
Does it go with Pearl Michaels?
No.
Is she going to wear both?
I think so. The pearls that she has are actually, I think they're from my grandmother. Mm-hmm. I think my mom gave them that to Marion.
They're gorgeous.
Very nice. That's a big set.
Yeah. Huge. Chunky.
Do you have your wedding
rings,
Brian, in your pocket?
Yeah. Grace wanted to do just, reading a set things, but I added a couple things in the beginning.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah, ad lib.
Put some flavor in.
Ad lib, yeah. Throw her off.
Yeah.
Throw her off.
Ooh.
I really didn't think we'd spend the minutes leading up to this wedding with a necklace.
Yes, you did.
You know you did.
What's that, Brian? Your favorite food is lobster?
It's like strikingly red. And then your fingers aren't, so it's really striking.
It looks worse than it is.
At least you're not bubbling.
Yeah. No, this really isn't a man's.
Oh, I didn't see that earlier. Oh.
Should see his arms.
Didn't you only... Because I sprayed suntan lotion, but only on your neck. You didn't have any...
Only on your neck!
Yeah, your neck is actually okay.
Yeah.
Neck looks good. That's good news.
Thank goodness.
It's a good thing you're not a dermatologist, because I feel like if you went back and saw patients, you'd be like...
That would not be good.
You're telling me not to go out the sun?
Are you nervous?
No, not really.
Don't be nervous about it.
Well, what's happening
like today? Kevin said, I've already been to so many ceremonies.
Right.
And, variations.
You're old head at this.
So, I don't know. I'll probably get a little nervous up on stage at some point.
Yeah.
But then all I have to do is stand there and then I read the vows.
Yeah, don't.
But
it's basically.
It's when you read
yeah,
the vows.
Don't, yeah.
Like if you jump the gun,
I'm
in trouble.
That's the yeah, that's true.
You should practice them, Brian.
What?
You should practice them. Have you read them out loud?
Yeah, I've read them out loud. I'm gonna be reading them off the piece of paper though, because I didn't commit them to memory.
Oh, put them away. Just read it. Just memory. Just ad lib it.
Speak from the heart.
The whole thing.
Grace slaps them on stage.
Yeah. Where's your paper? Where's your paper?
Does she have hers?
Yeah, she made me print it out this morning because she forgot to.
Nice big.
Big font.
Big font.
Yeah.
What is it? 4 pages long? 3-4 pages?
Yeah, it's just like.
It is. No, it's a term paper.
Your stuff, I think.
Do I have to give some stuff today too? I thought I'd just introduce you. And
this
now
is Brian.
Here
this
is Brian.
Jazz hands.
International jazz.
And Grace.
It's a good thing we didn't tell Annie that because we might actually stand up.
Yeah.
Oh, that would be funny if all of you up there. That would be really funny.
Instead of clapping, we'll do that.
I might have to pause and look over to you to see if he's doing it.
It sounds like maybe people are getting here, are they? I think
yeah,
can
there's
see
a lot
them.
Of people here.
It's cool.
A lot of people.
Yeah, we can kind of see down there.
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh, we can look down onto the.
Yeah.
Well, not under the room, but.
Just into the.
Oh, we go down there.
No, we can't see anybody.
No, I guess maybe they're not seating anyone yet.
Shocking that.
I was noticing they know.
Yeah.
I love the shoeless look for you guys.
It's
the
sockless
look, rather.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah.
You didn't like it this morning.
I think I just wanted. I didn't say that. I just wanted to make sure you were the only one without socks. That's all I care about.
Everyone
else is without socks, that's great. But if you were the only one, I thought, well, it may not be so cool.
Yeah. You got the casual medal from the bachelor's party and refused at the wedding.
Yeah.
Right. So the medals are going in this pocket.
That's right. No socks with deck shoes in the boat.
Cell phones on silent or
yes.
Turn them off.
Yeah. I
can't
find mine, so.
That's
fine.
Where
room.
Is that orange bag? Where is that?
It's with the babysitter.
Yeah, our babysitter took it out.
I hope she was your babysitter. I gave her some shit.
Yeah,
she's my jeez, Paul. Somebody on the beach.
They're like, oh, I'll take the bag.
So, Brian, I've been asked twice so far if I'm a minister.
Nice.
Yeah.
You should go along with that.
Yes.
We'll just call you Father.
Yes.
Yeah, then you can really confuse them by actually calling your Father.
Yeah.
See, I don't really need this.
Ryan's locked and loaded and ready to go.
Are you going to be filming the... Put it in your pocket and film the service so efficiently?
Yeah. No, I don't think so.
So we can't take our cameras out and take pictures of people when we're at home?
That would be a little distracting.
I
if
guess
we
so.
Maybe if only if it's a really big camera with
yeah,
like a
right.
huge flash.
With a huge lens.
Umbrella lights come in from the side.
And then the jazz hits.
Yeah.
We'd be the worst wedding party ever.
Yeah.
Grace would be like, shoot, you all dead.
You all did.
I kill you.
What time is it?
9:54.
Yeah. 20 minutes.
20 minutes. That's probably
good,
really
point.
Good point.
Yeah, let's see it again. Sit back down. Back down. Come on, do it.
Okay, well, then he needs to be standing.
Okay, gotta be standing. This is...
Oh
yeah, getting close.
Are we ready?
No flight risks. Oh, this is a special moment. Oh, beautiful. Just gorgeous. Oh, get in there close.
Yeah. Oh, my neck is too big.
That was really touching. It's so red. I can see them from here. You have blood on your hands.
It's crazy because it's all here.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah,
blood fingers.
Get up in the morning, I can't keep it in. I'm falling all over myself and I could jump out of my skin. Wanna break the door down just to greet the day. It's more certain to keep my blues away. And I sing la, 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 and I sing la, 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 and it can settle the sadness and the voices in my head. When I'm in the glow of the warmth you throw, I'm
and your relatives, if I had enough time, I would name all of you, into our family and thank everyone for coming today. What a joy to celebrate with people from all over the country. We're thrilled that our nephew, Ameya, is representing our entire family in India. And delighted to be with friends dating back decades. Pari and Lopa, Ashok and Sophia, Brian's godfather, Peter, James, who is like a brother to my brother, and Debbie and Audrey, who are like sisters to me. We're so happy that my brother's family is here, as well as Tom and Erica. She's there? Okay. Erica's Brian's sister, with whom Brian as a child shared his passion for Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Young Brian's behaviors were not always in sync with those of other children. During story time at the library, while other preschoolers were sitting still, Brian would be poking paper clips into electrical outlets. In his Montessori toddler class, Brian's attempt to communicate with the fish resulted in breaking the classroom aquarium. In India, at age 7, Brian ate an entire pound of mango fudge called Amba Barfi shortly before we were trapped in a 3-hour traffic jam between Pune and Bombay. Fortunately for us all, there were fields near the road. I love that Brian and his friends had a legitimate outlet for creative expression, but I was relieved that their cable TV show never aired as scheduled. Few parents would have appreciated such unbridled genius.
Video.
As a freshman engineering student, Brian learned how to catapult overly ripened fruit out of his dorm window onto the heads of unsuspecting passersby. When a college party was raided by campus police, Brian's speech team experience helped him talk his way out of charges. He convincingly claimed that he was in the bathroom rather than in the living room drinking beer with his buddies. Fortunately, by the time Brian met Grace in Cincinnati, he was already on a righteous path at Procter & Gamble, saving the world one shampoo at a time. All jokes aside, Madhu and I could not be prouder parents, and we're in awe of all that Grace and Brian accomplished during their 2 years in Boston and past 30 days here in Santa Monica. Family and friends, please join me as I raise my glass and wish the bride and groom a wonderful marriage and a happy and healthy life together. Brian and Grace, we love you. Best wishes on your wedding day and always.
Looking back, it wasn't the most nurturing environment for forming a lifelong friendship. We were entering the most painfully awkward stage of puberty. And as late bloomers, lovers of all things nerdy, we were bigger fish to fry than worrying about who would turn out to be our post-college friends. Being forced to communicate in basic and often misguided Spanish, we had to make do with halting conversations about our possession of hunger, our love of going to the cinema, and making up stories about our favorite made-up character, un hombre gordo en una chaqueta pequeña. A fat man in a jacket, exactly what I'm saying. But against all odds, I, a chubby preteen with a straight out of 1995 butt cut hairdo, and Brian, a Jewish Indian genius boy, started becoming good friends. As we entered high school, we broadened our horizons by becoming members of the very elite and very macho video club. Our after-school sessions were spent providing hard-hitting video game reviews and aping every skit possible from late-night television. Fake interviews, barely funny newspaper ads, and crafting historical, comical recreations in the style of Conan O'Brien. Remember the talking picture heads? We were real visionaries.
Yes.
However, I think the bulk of our time there was spent playing epic four-player Nintendo 64 matches using four separate TVs. In all honesty, what would you expect a group of nerdy teenagers to do with a room full of electronic equipment? I know what you're thinking. How in the world did this kid end up with a beautiful, intelligent woman like Grace? Wait for it, I'm getting it. After graduation, Brian headed off to Cornell, and I attended Indiana University Bloom. Brian and I had an easier time staying in touch due to his junior year internship at future employer Procter & Gamble. Brian visited IU on weekends during that year, to the point so many that it almost felt like he transferred there. We made some ridiculous music together, which has already been discussed, and we started cultivating a mutual obsession with Guitar Hero and eventually graduated to rock band. After college, I moved to Indianapolis and Brian took a full-time position at BMG. During one of Brian's regular weekend visits, he mentioned he recently met a really interesting fellow P&G employee named Grace. He gushed about how nice and cool she seemed, and he probably said, "She's absolutely gorgeous," at least five times. Before dinner, Brian excused himself to make a quick phone call to Grace before dinner. Well over 30 minutes passed before he ate. When he came back into the room, Brian seemed animated and energized by his conversation with his new crush. I don't want to spoil the surprise, but it's highly likely the story ends with Brian getting a girl. A few months later, I spent a weekend visiting Brian in Cincinnati with some fellow high school friends who might be sitting at that table. Shortly after arriving at Brian's house to a dinner party in full swing, Brian and I made a quick trip to the grocery store. On the way there, I asked him how his new relationship with Grace was going, and his answer took me by surprise. Not only did he inform me that things were going really well, he said, "I really think this is the girl I'm going to marry." Mm-hmm. Fast forwarding a few years, Ron and I had the unexpected pleasure of both ending up in the Boston area. Lauren, my fiance, and I relocated in 2008 for her job there as well, and Brian and Grace moved out in 2009 for Brian to pursue his MBA in Harvard. Having our close friends nearby made being 1,000 miles away from home a lot easier. And we got the chance to really get to know Grace. We also got to witness our friends blossom into amazing parents right before our eyes. The first time Lauren and I met Forrest, we of course instantly loved him. But we couldn't get over how naturally and enthusiastically Brian took on the role of becoming a father. It was really cool to see a longtime friend taking it on in full stride and being great with Forrest. Relaxing at home with Grace and baby Forrest, we had never seen Brian so happy. Fast forward once again to today, here we are in this gorgeous setting, celebrating the life that Brian and Grace have built together. I'm incredibly honored to be here, and I'm very proud of the husband and father my friend has become. Brian and Grace, I wish you many, many years of building happy memories together. Let's all raise our glasses to Brian and Grace. Congratulations.
I am so happy to be here to share this moment with everybody. And I have a few words about sharing. My sister Grace taught me to share. I have a Grace. My parents brought her home and that was it. So we shared parts. We shared snacks. We shared attention. And we had to. But we were very lucky, and as we got older, we were able to share and glad to share our hopes and dreams, our ridiculous inside jokes that we laughed till tears rolled down our faces. Priceless moments, and this is one of those moments. When Grace was in elementary school, she she was in a church program, and she had a lot of lines, and she sang a solo. She was an archangel. And she was so good. And I remember sitting in the dark, looking at her, and wanting to jump up and woohoo and say, that's my sister, that's my baby sister. Didn't she do good? So now I can do that. I can stand up today and say, that's my little sister. I'm so proud of her. Grace and Brian, thank you for allowing me to share this very special moment with you. I feel truly blessed, and Brian, I am so proud now to call you my brother-in-law. Thank you. I'm going to pass the mic to Rita.
Imagine my life without my older sister, Grace. I simply can't. Although we are a few years apart, we've always shared a special bond unlike any other. Growing up, Grace taught me how to write my name, how to dress cool, the importance of sharing, and of course, when she borrowed my favorite outfit. We're the same size. Great. As my older sister, I've always looked up to you. I'm so proud of the woman you are today. You've been a part of every important thing in my life, and therefore I feel honored and privileged to be a part of this moment in yours. On behalf of Jenny and myself, we wish you many years of happiness and great joy. Brian, Grace, and Forrest. So we're going to raise our glasses. Cheers to you both.
Cheers. Cheers.
Molotov.
Yeah. Thank you. Special thanks to Jeff Palmer, my best man.
scene, and a huge help in getting ready for today. Thank you to Gracie's beautiful bridesmaids. I helped her get ready throughout the day since like 4 o'clock in the morning. To Gracie's maid of honor, Sarah Solis, who was kind enough to do things like lug a 50-pound duffel bag full of those teacups from New York City all the way out there. While our sisters, Jenny, Rini, and Erica, may be far away geographically from where we live, we can always count on them to be some of the first people we call when we're faced with a difficult decision. And we appreciate having them in our lives as well. Finally, we want to give special recognition today to our parents here, Frank, Karen, and Madhu. You guys have been tremendous role models in the love, care, and support you've shown from the time we were born. You have our endless appreciation for the role you play in our lives, and we owe the strength of our family to you. So with that, I'd like to raise a glass and toast to all of you for making the trip. To lifelong friends and family, thank you very much and enjoy the rest of the afternoon. Cheers.
Here for a Oh my God,
Yeah.
Amaya! Sister Dan.
Yep.
The house telling you to close your eyes.
And some things I can't even trust myself.
It's killing me to see this way.
'Cause though the truth may bury this, ship will carry our body safe to the shore.
Tell her that I miss our little talks.
Soon it will be over and buried with our past.
We used to play outside when we were young and full of life and full of love.
Some days I don't know if I am wrong or right.
Your mind is playing tricks on you, my dear.
'Cause though the truth may bury this, ship will carry our